Okay, sit down and shut up. I am Supreme Leader Darling, and like my grandfather and my father before me, ich bin ein TOK teacher. Today we will look at TOK essay title 4 of the May 2023 examination series. The importance of this essay title to our IB security cannot be stressed enough. Writing a TOK essay is a challenge that confronts us all. Yet I, Supreme Leader Darling, say we should build a wall between those of us who can write this essay and those of us who cannot. With blood, toil, tears and sweat, we will write this essay and assure victory at all cost. We will write it in the classroom, we will write it at home, we will write it on the beaches. Now, I put you in the good care of Deputy Darling to talk you through the process. Some of you may be too young, too naive to actually understand this essay title, but you will listen and you must pay attention. So, without further ado, I give you Deputy Darling.
Hello, I am Deputy Darling and we are going to be talking about essay title 4, which is, do you agree that it is astonishing that so little knowledge can give us so much power? Bertrand Russell. Discuss with reference to the natural sciences and one other area of knowledge. Now, when we look at this essay title, because that's what we should do straight away, we should look at the essay title, we should break it down. When we look at this particular essay title, I think we will immediately be drawn to the quotation, which is, it is astonishing that so little knowledge can give us so much power. When we are looking at this particular quotation, we need to define knowledge and we need to define power. And power is a word that can have multiple meanings. We can have power, apply power in many different ways. So that needs to be carefully considered. We also need to quantify so little and so much. What exactly constitutes so little knowledge? What exactly constitutes so much power? So think carefully about those terms as well. Remember that another key word in this quotation is astonishing. Astonishing. So we are surprised, we are shocked, we are amazed. It makes us go, wow, that so little knowledge can give us so much power. Ultimately, you need to say whether or not you agree or disagree with that quotation, that statement. If it's a do you agree question, then obviously we need a yes or no answer. I agree or I don't agree. Do you think Christmas is the most wonderful time of the year? Well, in that case, you need to say, yes, I agree, no, I don't. Exactly the same with this particular question. So, do you agree that it is astonishing that so little knowledge can give us so much power? Really, really think hard about the semantics of this particular essay title. It's quite confusing. You're not being asked whether you think so little knowledge can give us so much power. you're being asked whether you agree or disagree with the idea that it is astonishing that so little knowledge can give us so much power. Maybe there is already an implication here. We can assume that so little knowledge can give us so much power. We are being asked to explore whether or not we think that is astonishing. This is a quote from Bertrand Russell. You don't need to worry about that too much. Don't worry too much about researching Bertrand Russell or finding the wider context of the quotation. You can just run with what you have here in the essay title. And remember, there's an instruction at the end. Discuss with reference to the natural sciences and one other area of knowledge. So this is one of those essay titles that requires you to talk about a specific AOK, in this case, the natural sciences. So you must talk about the natural sciences, and once you've done that, talk about another AOK as well. Okay, so that is a deconstruction of the essay title. Okay, so let's start delving into the overall essay title. Before we get into the nitty-gritty of whether or not the statement is astonishing, and to what extent we agree or disagree with that statement, I would like to just think about the quotation in general, as a starting point, I'm trying to make my thinking explicit to you here. So the question is this: how can so little knowledge give us so much power? That's how I am going to begin my exploration. Now, I think there is a danger with this essay title. I am concerned that a lot of people are going to jump to hard power. They're going to think about politics, they're going to point out people like Donald Trump, and they're going to show how they are incredibly stupid, yet they are in positions of power. And look, there is a point to be made there. However, I would warn you against going down this route too much. Remember, politics is not really an AOK. It's an optional theme, but it's not an AOK. You could connect it to the human sciences, but I would encourage you to think more about the human sciences as an area of knowledge and how human scientists work, as opposed to just a story in the news that you are making a random connection with. So I remember once marking a TOK essay where a student talked all about the 2016 American presidential election. That student didn't get many marks because they didn't connect the real life situation to an AOK. Because they were quite passionate about this situation, they ended up just rambling about politics, and that meant they weren't really able to engage with the nature of knowledge, which is ultimately what we are trying to do with our TOK essays. So I think you might want to consider this point about hard power, but I would warn you against using that as your sole point. Indeed, what I would encourage you to do is think a bit more about soft power and how maybe little knowledge could actually lead to a lot of power in a soft way. By a soft way, I mean we are able to make sense of the world around us. We are able to access certain information. We are able to engage with other knowers. Power is a relative term. So much power is a relative term. And I think it would be worth defining so much power along the lines of soft power. with so little knowledge, we are able to gain a tremendous amount of power in terms of processing the world around us. It doesn't take a genius to be able to engage with society and knowledge on a basic level. But the results of such engagement could be tremendous, and that could be defined as power. Now, I'd like you to think about this. I'm just thinking about the WOKs, the ways of knowing. I think we could make points about all of the ways of knowing, but I want to focus on just sense perception, reason, and language. These are quite basic skills, so to speak. We can all perceive things with our senses. We can all engage in basic reasoning, knowing that one thing is bigger than another. A plus B equals C. I don't know. So we can do these things without too much insight, too much knowledge. Language on a basic level is something that maybe doesn't require too much knowledge. But being able to perceive, being able to reason, being able to communicate gives us a lot of power in our everyday lives. Now, what I would like to do is I would like to apply this line of thinking to each one of the AOKs. So I'm thinking about the arts. I mean, children can draw. And I'm sure we all drew as children. I'm sure we've all seen children's paintings. Even though children don't have much artistic knowledge, even though they don't have too much psychomotor ability, they are still able to produce drawings that represent maybe their home, their family. They also, not just children now, people in general, without much knowledge, we all have the ability to engage with and enjoy particularly mainstream art. You don't need to be a genius to sit down and watch and enjoy a Marvel film. You can even have a conversation with your friends after it. And just the basic knowledge of being able to watch the movie, the knowledge of being able to make some judgments about the movie, and the knowledge of being able to communicate your ideas. It's so basic, but it gives us so much power in the realm of the arts. Let's think about history. Well, you don't need too much knowledge in order to recall dates, recall major figures. You might want to think about Bloom's taxonomy. Bloom's taxonomy has a ranking of low-order thinking skills compared to higher-order thinking skills. Knowledge, basic knowledge, recall. These are things that are all low-order thinking skills, and we are able to use these low-order thinking skills, which require very little knowledge, in order to recall dates and major historical figures that then give us access to a much wider range of historical knowledge. We are able to recall basic accounts of major events, and maybe we could understand some implications of those events. So, for example, we know that when we gave Nazi Germany too much leeway through the policy of appeasement, it didn't actually appease the Nazis. They still went to war. So maybe we know not to do that again. All of this requires very little knowledge, but it gives us so much power that we can then apply to our wider historical thinking and even to our everyday lives. Mathematics. I mean, it doesn't take a genius to count. It doesn't take a genius to compare different quantities, to know that 2 is bigger than 1, to know that one circle is bigger than another. We don't need much knowledge to handle money, to conduct basic, simple sums. But particularly in terms of money, it's through this basic knowledge that we are able to engage with a society that uses money as its main means of currency. And that in itself gives us a sense of power. Think about the financial freedom that might come along with such use of money, such handling of money. That requires very basic knowledge. The natural sciences, I have underlined the natural sciences and I have put the writing in red because obviously you need to talk about the natural sciences. So observation, basic sense perception is needed in order to observe natural phenomena. This doesn't actually require too much skill, too much knowledge. We are all able to look out of the window and ask ourselves, why is the sun in a particular position? We have knowledge of our own bodies in terms of health. We know if we're feeling hungry or we are thirsty. That doesn't require too much knowledge, but obviously it's vital. If we weren't able to decide when we are hungry, when we are thirsty, we wouldn't know when to eat or drink, and we'd all die, and we wouldn't have any power then. And we all have the ability to learn through experience, maybe to varying extents, but we all hopefully have some ability to experience certain things, to experiment, and then to find information from that experience, from those experiments. And that is the basis, the core of the scientific method. Let's observe things, let's try it out, and let's work out some kind of meaning here. Let's try and deduct some kind of knowledge. And the human sciences, obviously very similar to the natural sciences in terms of that basic scientific method. I would just add that we can recognize emotions, our own emotions, the emotions of others, with very little knowledge. Obviously, again, there are varying degrees of emotional intelligence, but hopefully we are all able to engage with the recognition of emotions to a certain extent. And we are able to identify good or bad behaviour. Or even if we can't reach conclusions ourselves, we are able to take on board what other people tell us, and we are able to then apply those definitions of good and bad behaviour. And that's what the human sciences are all about. The human sciences are about human behaviour, the scientific study of human behaviour. So look, I haven't talked about anything amazing here. All I've talked about is very basic things. But all of these little things, all of this little knowledge gives us so much soft power in our everyday lives and across all of the AOKs. Okay, so we have now talked about some initial ideas regarding how a little knowledge can give us so much power. But remember, that is not our essay title. Our essay title is, do you agree that it is astonishing that so little knowledge can give us so much power? So what we need to do now, if we actually need to look at both sides, we need to look at, yes, I agree, no, I disagree. And we need to have arguments for both sides so that we can then make a decision about which side we are going to support in our essay. So let's begin with, yes, I agree that it is astonishing that there is so little, that so little knowledge gives us so much power. I have a suggestion box. This suggestion box has lots of ideas for us. Let's have a look at the first idea. The first idea is, be careful what you say. Supreme Leader Dowling is watching you. I don't know what that one means. Okay, the next idea. Yes, I agree that it is astonishing that so little knowledge can give us so much power, because I just can't believe it to be true. Look around us. There are so many experts in positions of power, of leadership, and they obviously know a lot. Think about the natural sciences, an important AOK for this particular question. In the natural sciences, we have the World Health Organization, led by experts, and they have the ability to make some drastic decisions. And we trust them in doing so because they have the knowledge to do so. So yeah, I mean, it's hard to actually believe that so little knowledge can give us so much power. So therefore, it's astonishing. The next point, we are not comfortable with the idea. And I think what this relates to is the notion that with great power comes great responsibility, as they say in Spider-Man. And we like to think that the people in power or people with power, they have a responsibility for their knowledge and a responsibility for their actions, and they should adhere to a duty of care. It's not nice to think that those people in positions of responsibility might not actually have too much knowledge to begin with. I'm thinking here about mathematics. I'm thinking about a real life situation that I might have mentioned in other videos, Sally Clark. Sally Clark was a mother. Her child died because of cot death. It was natural causes. But Sally Clark was suspected of killing her child. It went to trial, and Sally Clark was found guilty of killing her child, mainly because a mathematical expert was brought into the courtroom, and he gave some statistics talking about how unlikely it was that the child died of natural causes. Because of those statistics, because of that expert analysis, Sally Clark was jailed, and she was innocent. So it was such a travesty. It turns out that the statistics were wrong. It turns out that the expert didn't actually know as much as he thought. That disrupts our whole idea of experts with power, and maybe makes us feel less secure in their power because their knowledge is so limited. And that insecurity that it produces in us, that discomfort, is something that we might then find astonishing when we look at this particular quote from Bertrand Russell. Another point here, it's counterintuitive. Maybe that goes back to what I said earlier about we just can't believe it's true. And then the next point is, ignorance is bliss. That's interesting, and that almost feels counterintuitive in itself. We like to think that a lot of knowledge is something that gives us power. A lot of knowledge is something that we should all strive for. But maybe there's some credence to that well-known phrase, ignorance is bliss. Maybe not knowing too much can lead us to a sense of bliss where we don't have to worry about everything that we do know. The idea of actively deciding not to know something in order to have the power to achieve an elevated status, or the power to achieve a more ideal state of bliss, is something that goes against everything that we're taught in school, that we need to acquire knowledge. It's what we're taught in society. But being ignorant and knowing so little could actually lead to a lot of individual power. That just seems so crazy to us that we find the whole notion of a little knowledge giving us power astonishing. And now we need to look at the other side of the argument, which is that I disagree. It is not astonishing that so little knowledge can give us so much power. Again, we will look at our suggestion box. So suggestion number one, run away, he wants to kill you. Again, I don't know what that means. Number two, it's obvious. Maybe it's already obvious that so little knowledge can give us so much power. There are lots of examples of that that I alluded to earlier on in today's video. So why should we be surprised? Therefore, I would disagree with the claim that we are astonished by the quotation. Okay, let's see what else they have in here. Little knowledge is relative. That's an interesting point as well. We need to ask ourselves, what does little knowledge mean? Because you could have a little knowledge in terms of you can hardly read or write, or we could say that even experts in the grand scheme of things have little knowledge compared to all of the knowledge that could possibly be obtained in the universe. So we could maybe describe every knower as someone who only possesses a little knowledge. Okay, next one. Power is power. That's important. Think about the role of authority. You know, the people who want to be in power will be in power no matter what you think or say. It doesn't matter how much they know. Through sheer force and brutality, they can still oppress the masses. Therefore, we should not be astonished because knowledge doesn't come into the matter. And then final one, I'm going to tell the truth now. There's actually no, all these pieces of paper, they're all blank. I'm just trying to do all of this from memory. So there's actually no paper left in here. But let's just pretend there's a piece of paper. Oh, wow, the Dunning-Kruger effect. The Dunning-Kruger effect is a really interesting psychological phenomenon. And you can check it out by watching this video. So the Dunning-Kruger effect shows us that we are not aware of our own lack of knowledge. That's basically all you need to know about it. So if we are not aware of our own lack of knowledge, and maybe other people are not aware of our lack of knowledge, then it's not surprising that so little knowledge can lead to so much power, because the Dunning-Kruger effect shows us that we all maybe, or a lot of people, suffer from this problem. So the odds are that there will be a lot of people with very little knowledge who do end up in power, or with some kind of power in their lives. And here is just a little summary of all of those ideas. Quite complicated, I'm sorry, but there'll be a picture, you can have a look at that. Okay, just a note here on potential essay structures. You need to either decide that you agree or you disagree. If you agree, you are saying that it is astonishing. And what you could do is make one point with reference to the natural sciences and another point with reference to another AOK. Alternatively, you could agree and you could have one point where you refer to both the natural sciences and the other AOK, and then your second point where you refer to the natural sciences and another AOK. It's the exact same for disagree. Those are the options available to you. And there is also maybe an option to explore both sides. On one hand, you agree. On the other hand, you disagree. Again, you could either have one section dedicated to the natural sciences, another section dedicated to a different AOK, or you could have both AOKs in both sections. That is up to you. Normally, I end the videos with some bonus questions. Today, I don't have any bonus questions. I have bonus quotations. So the first one, knowledge is power, from Sir Francis Bacon. The second one, a little knowledge is a dangerous thing, so is a lot. You might want to ask yourself,
to what extent you agree with these particular quotations, and maybe that might lead to some interesting ideas that you can somehow apply in your essay. And that is everything from me, so I now hand you back over to the capable hands of Supreme Leader Dowling.
Thank you to Deputy Dowling for giving us that presentation. So, let us get on with the job at hand. Let us write that TOK essay. But before we begin, please arise for our national anthem.